said for me just a moment.
Hallelujah.
Gotta kind of pull myself together. Hey, my folks just break me down. Y'all just broke me down. So I gotta kind of, pull it all back together. Mercy, His loving kindness. You are the living manifestation of the message that I'm about to preach. I'm so excited. When I say I'm excited, I mean I'm excited. I don't sound excited. The visionary is Pastor Lena. There's my friend here. She's a best friend. Well, we'll talk about her while she's back there. Because I am ever encouraged whenever the enemy presents a situation that would seemingly be greater than God. Seemingly. I'm ever reminded of where God has brought her from. And the ministry, and I get so encouraged. She was joking me because for those that know me, after 8 o'clock at night, you talking to the wall, baby. I've never been a night person. I'm the one that will call you at 4 o'clock in the morning and want to know why you're sleeping. So she was telling my friend, Pastor Rachel, she said, you want a good prayer? You call Dr. Lisa at 5 a.m.
That's the truth.
And you want to talk to a rock, call her after 8. But I'm just excited about where God is taking the ministry. And know this, I honor them so much. And Pastor Jamie, I love you. I know he was just there. So we thank God. There he is. Amen. I tell you, that's the most humble man I know. If I was a man, I'd pick him. Just a humble, wonderful man of God. And I honor the Lord for them and for my friend, this is my good girl friend, Gail. I'll tell y'all that story in a few years to come. Pastor Rachel Wilson, she came all the way from Greensboro, North Carolina. That's my girl. She's cute, I told her, we're going to tear some stuff up today, all right?
All right.
So her micro's going to go everywhere.
All right, now.
So she better get another rubber band and pull it all back.
That's all right. That's all right.
We came to work. Is that all right?
That's all right.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Giving y'all a few minutes. I know y'all ate, so I'm trying to get everybody's stuff together because God's about to do some great things in this place today. Anybody believe that but me? All I need is one person. Who got my back out there? And I ain't scared. God knows I ain't scared. I came all the way to Virginia, but I'm from New York, so y'all know I ain't scared. Because God's about to set it off for the second chance. Say this part of my testimony real quick because it's for somebody that's here. And I tell you, I just love God. Play softly, baby. God is just setting an atmosphere in this place for what He is about to do and for what God has shown me. I'm grateful. I'm grateful for your life. And I say this to you because there's another woman sitting here that may be in your same situation. See, when God called me, and women, I tell you, we need you. And after I deliver the message that the Lord has placed on my heart today, you'll understand how crucial and how important you are to the kingdom of God.
Yes.
When God called me to the ministry, I said, ain't no way, ain't no way. And that's the clean version. I was like, I don't think so. And I'm going to tell you why. Can I tell you why? I'm grateful to the Lord that I fell in love with God before I really got caught up in the church. And it wasn't that I didn't love God. I just couldn't do the faithful. Maybe not y'all. That's my story. I said I couldn't do that faking plastic. I'm coming back up here because that was just too deep for the religious folks. Can I talk to you, boo?
Yeah,
I was like, God, ain't no way. The most drastic people I ever met was up in church. See, in the world, fuck will tell you like it is. You know who don't like you. We over there. We good. You don't like me. I don't like you. We good. But I got confused when I came to the church. Because folk would speak in tongue and not speak to me. Everybody got this kind of person, they family. If the stuff ain't right, I'ma tell you it ain't right. I ain't gonna sit there, you know you lying. I'ma be like, thank you, amen. I was like, God, I'ma mess this all up. You know what? You know, I'm not the person you want behind this pulpit, because I'ma tell it like a T.I. is. That ain't what church is about, and God ain't about. You don't want me, God. Okay. See, because I ain't the only one that has been, you know, beat up by the plastic phone. But then I fell in love with God.
That's it. Yes, 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 yes.
And then the church didn't bother me as much. I'm helping somebody. See, the only way you ever gonna get through the church is you got to get real close to God. It's gonna make some more sense in a minute. Because see, the church will beat you down if you ain't careful. See right there, I told you, this is my message. See, because the church has a way of trying to. See, I don't understand. Am I right? Because you know I'm going to just do me anyway. I don't understand how people can smoke 6 to 10, 15 cigarettes a day for 10, 15 years, and all of a sudden they get saved and can't stand the smell of cigarettes. Somebody sit next to them with a little smoke on them and they just get to shaking. What's your problem? I'm getting somewhere. I'm getting somewhere. See, we got to break up a lot of the folly groundness in here, because it's a whole lot of perpetrators up in the house today. And I'm going to set all the perpetrators free so more of you can come to the kingdom. Because what God's about to do up in Second Chance, Pastor, it is going to require that we be set free today. Can I talk?